the stern of the boat, and you'll notice you've got a hole right here, and it's kind of flat at the back. Not all kayaks do that. What this is going to work great for is if you're going to mount a trolling motor or something to it. You've got a nice flat place back here, and you've got a place for your cables to be able to run through. Also in the back here, you've got a carrying handle, of course, and then you've got an access hatch. So I believe that's a 6-inch access hatch with an 8-inch ring, so plenty of room to be able to get stuff. And then you'll notice you've got this large tank well. So you can fit a black pack and a cooler back here. This is a very long, long tank well, which is great. You've got a couple of flush mount rod holders here. And then you'll see these guys right here. They're on both sides. What that is the butt stager for the rod tubes. And the rod tubes will sneak up here, are right here. So for those of you guys who like to fish rivers, or if you're fishing where there's lots of trees and you need to get under the trees and that kind of stuff, or you have to launch in an area where there are a lot of overhangs and things like that, these are going to come in really handy. That way the highest thing up is going to be you. I know some of you guys like to fish the salt and you have to cross under some bridges, or even some freshwater guys have to cross under some very low bridges to get into some areas or go through some culverts. These rod stagers are going to be perfect for that. Got a couple of scuppers here in the back, and then you've got this chair. So this is a beast of a chair. It is wider than most chairs. It's got 6 adjustment points on it, and so you're able to tighten it and loosen it as you want. And it fits onto this frame here, and this frame has tighten down points, so you can adjust this thing from basically the tank well all the way up here, depending on how heavy the load is that you're carrying. So you can slide that all the way up. That is integrated track, you'll see, on both sides, all the way up, so you can mount a lot of things to the floor, not have to have them up on the side rails if you don't want them. And then this right here, I use it a lot of times as a paddle keeper. I can slide my paddle. You'll notice the groove right there. I slide my paddle in there and it holds that. What I also do is I will undo this, put my rods in the rod stager, and just loop that over. And then that adds me an extra level of security on those rods. Then moving forward a little more, you've got another area up here. Basically is a front tank well, if you will, that you can store different things there. You've got track that's elevated, so you'll be able to see it here. So this is the floor track, and then this is the elevated track. And so you can mount things here. What I did most recently on my most recent trip, you can tell the boat's dirty. Had one day of sunshine, so I had to get out. I mounted my fish finder and my swing over the top swing arm transducer mount up here, so it's easy to remove, fast, quick, in a hurry. Close to that, you've got this front hatch. So this front hatch has four places to batten it down, basically, so that it stays pretty watertight. It's got a seal all the way around it. It's got a bucket. You do have access to your rod tubes and lots of space inside. Zip tie. So lots of cool features built into this. And this is how the boat comes if you just buy it. So if you're just getting the new Canoe Pursuit, it's going to come with a seat. It's going to come basically a clean deck. So you've got plenty of customization, places to go, things to do. You can mount all kinds of things to it, or you can keep it completely simple.